I owe each and one of you a really, really big apology. My previous video was about my Honda project, which I was really excited about. One with the VTEC wheels, the seats and everything like that. 2 days after the car got spread, the car got sold. Me and my daddy decided we're going to sell the car. We would like to keep the caddy bucky we bought for him. So I'm rather going to make that my next project. And try to do a few things on the bucky. I bought a few things for the bucky already, like rims and a grill and lights and everything like that, and a front lip for the bucky as well. So now I'm just waiting on the drop place for the bucky, and I need to get coilovers in front before I slam that thing down. But now, the only thing keeping me up is that I need a tailgate for the bucky, as well as a sail at the back. But enough of that. I would like to show you guys this freaking car. You guys already seen the title. This was or is my main project. I bought this car. This past 2-3 years, and what you guys see here, it's fully me. It describes me fully. This is my car. So I hope you guys enjoy the video. So this is the almighty leveler. I've had the car since 2015. My dad bought the car in 2015. I bought the car by him in 2016. Owned the car the full out 2017 and sold it in 2017 December month. Bought the car back a few weeks ago, full out a month ago. What I've done to the car and specs of the car. The car is a 1.4 Velocity. The car has a Cowley branch. It has a Viper branch of Buffalo, and it has a Cowley 50mm exhaust one. The car has a cold air induction with a 272 Instascam and a vernier. Interior of the car is originally Velocity interior. Nothing changed in the car of the interior. Only put in a double din. Like you guys can see in the video, I have two triangle star signs in, running on a 13,000 watt star sign Rogue. And I've splits in the doors with, I think it's Sony splits if I'm not mistaken. And I have Sony 659s as well, hidden in the back, running on an 8000 watt 4 channel Targa. Car has a capacitor on as well, just for the little bit of, to put the cherry on the cake for the sound system. But I'm just gonna start up the car for you guys, so you guys can just see the idling of the car. Oh yeah, before I do that, just note the car does have coilovers in, as well as extended mountings. Just check out the extended mountings. So this is the extended spaces for your mountings. What happens is that you flip your mounting on top. You take it, it's basically underneath this piece of metal right here. So you flip it on top, you get the spacer right here, and you get the reinforcement plate. The reinforcement plate is cut exactly the size of the mounting. It might struggle to go in, but just remember, if you put in strong enough bolts and put in lockers, you don't have to worry about anything. Which I already mentioned is that the car has coilovers in. But something I forgot to mention is that the car can actually hit the ground. Like, I will be able to get with this rim right here, I'll able to get lip to arch fitment with this car. Due to I have extended mountings in, I have coilovers in, and I did C-knots the car. C-knots is not always recommended, but if you do a reinforcement plate on the C-knots, you can't go wrong. I was talking to a guy and he said, actually C-knots actually strengthens the strut in front of the car. Everybody has their own opinions. I don't believe him. I wouldn't say he's wrong, but I mean, like, reinforcing that piece of bar right in front wouldn't be a bad thing as well, especially when you teach C-knots. So this car was originally on a video of Joshua Vlog, so you guys can just subscribe to his YouTube channel. I'll put it right there. He's a buddy of mine. He has his own YouTube channel, Picking Forex. So he made a video for this Cape Town's first Wednesday, and my car actually appeared in that. And after that, the people actually start talking about my car, and I mean, like, I wouldn't say it's famous, but it still has a name for itself. The car has its imperfections right now after I sold the car due to the previous owner not leaking the car. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to I already rescued the car. I changed a lot of stuff on the car and I spent major money on this car. So I'm just going to give you guys a startup and you guys can see what this car actually sounds like. And the idle as well, the idle is a bit rough, especially on startup. So check this out. Right there, you guys can hear the car has a really rough idle. Personally, I like it because this was my type of exhaust I wanted to put in the car. Just note, this is a Kaoli exhaust, and a lot of people don't prefer Kaoli, but I full out prefer Kaoli above Powerflow. Not always, but with this car, I actually fell in love with the sound of the car. While the car is actually idling, I might as well just give you like a small riff on the car. I mean, like, who says no to a small riff? Ugh. Well guys, that was just like a small riff. Fuck this phone is dirty. That's just like a small riff on the car and like a small taste of the car. The car is very loud. And you guys could hear how fast the riff actually goes up. That's actually like a really good thing for me. Unfortunately the car's clutch is slipping, so I can't actually feel the full potential of the car. I mean, like, just like riffing this car up and starting it up each morning just makes me so excited. Like this car's like fucking so amazing. I'm just gonna give you guys a small preview of what the car looks like. I'm just gonna lower the car in front, just to give you guys like a small preview of what the car actually looks like when it's actually fully lowered. While the car is actually adding, so I'm just gonna grab the jack and the prank, and then I'll just lower the car for you guys like. I'm sure I showed you guys where the coil levels work. It's just you turn this all the way down and then you turn this one down. This is actually the locker, and this is actually the, I don't know what you call this, but what keeps the spring up. So yeah, let's turn this car down. I'm just gonna put the camera down right now because I can't do this and I can't multitask. Like, damn, look at that damn fitment, dope! I'm so freaking excited for this fitment. I never seen this car slammed with this rim on. I only got this rim like a few days ago. Just note that it's like, say, I'll say 3 centimeters thread lift, because I didn't turn it down all the way due to the rim's lip on the inside was in the way. So I didn't feel like removing the rim just to turn the car down. So this fitment is more than satisfying for me. I said I'm not gonna lower the car at the back because I just have the feels for it. So I only lowered the car in front. But damn, son. Girls be like, I have heels. I have heels longer than your dick. Bro, are your foot been tighter than your fucking pussy, girl? Look there. Damn. That was like the whole fucking crap meme, though. Well, like I said, I'm so excited for this footman right here. You don't get this footman anyway. Some people strike off the footman, and some people really considered or thought that my car was bagged. No, you guys just saw the car really has coilovers in, and the car actually goes flat. I don't have enough time today to turn the car full out, flat on the ground, and give you guys a nice flat video. I still have to go work later, and I still have to try and edit this video for the upload tomorrow. So, I'm so happy right now. Damn, look at that damn footman. Yeah, I wish Jody was here. I mean, like, he would have, like, lost his E on his head. He'd be like, this fucking footman, no. I know the car is still lower than in on the bricks, but I'm just going to give you guys a small preview of this car's sound system. Excuse the sound quality, because this phone's sound quality is terrible. But I'm just going to give you guys a small preview of the sound system in this car. The go-to song always, stir fry, shit. Man, damn, the car system is on fleek, bro. But damn, well, this car's fucking system is on fleek. Well, excuse that sound quality right there, because it's gonna be green a lot. So, this video though, and this car though. Well, I've gave you guys the full preview on the car. I don't know if I leave something out. You guys can already see what is done to the car. Like, there's small add-ons like the windshields and the spoiler on the car. And like, there's like smaller final details on the car, like the lip and the grill and the lights and everything. Oh fuck, I'm gonna lose my mind if I mention all this stuff to you guys and how much it cost. So, shout out to each and one of you for actually liking this video. I'm a fan of you too, though. So thanks for liking the video. Please subscribe to my channel. I have an Instagram page as well, so you can please just follow that. I'll put the link right there, or the name right there. You guys can just hit me up on Instagram on what video I should do next. If you guys like my content, what you don't like about my content. I am going to do a full out video of my car, TJ's car, and Jody's car. We all have city sport rooms, so we're going to roll together. We're going to ask, I don't know what's the guy's name. If I get the guy's name, I'm going to mention to you guys again. All I know, I think his surname is Assam or something like that. I'm gonna ask him to do a video of us. But please, like I said, link, subscribe to my fucking channel, please. Please subscribe to my channel, like this video, please share the shit out of this video. Dope.